This is Pegasus Launch Control at a mission elapsed time of 21 minutes, 42 seconds into the flight of the Iris spacecraft. And joining us now here at the console is Tim Dunn, our NASA Launch Director for tonight's mission. And Tim, first of all, tell us briefly what you know about the spacecraft at this point.
So, George, we're thrilled. We're very excited. Spacecraft, we've made initial contact with it through the TDRS network, gotten good data back. The solar arrays did begin to deploy, and everything is proceeding right on track with the nominal expected timeline after spacecraft separation from Pegasus.
Tell us about the flight. Early on, it seemed to go well, and then it got interesting toward the end in terms of what we were able to learn. So give us some insight on that.
Yeah, it was a thrilling afternoon here at Vandenberg Air Force Base as we watched the L-1011 prepare to take off and head out over the Pacific Ocean, head northwest, make its turn. We had relatively few issues. One minor range asset that's located down at Point Magoo gave us a little bit of trouble, but the range was able to bring that back in and online. We experienced a little bit of a signal issue with our FTS system. You may have heard the AGCs were erratic at times. That was mostly attributable to as we were traveling out and the orientation of the aircraft in relation to the ground assets here at Vandenberg and at the Western Range. Once we made the turn for coming back toward the south, AGCs locked in really well. We were able to do those final FTS checks, no problem.
That's the automatic gain control.
The automatic gain control on those AGC values, right. So that put us minutes away from launch. One of the critical events that happens with Pegasus is you activate a thermal battery on board Pegasus that is able to move the fins and the rudder on the vehicle. So we made that activation at approximately 45 seconds prior to drop, and then you may have heard the repeated call outs of fin sweep, and that's not fully unexpected. We don't typically see that in flight, but the procedure does account for it, and we reissued the command numerous times, and I think it was on about the fifth reissuance of that command. We did get movement with the fins, and once you get initial movement, you're verified that you're going to be good for flight. So we got through that. That was a very tense moment, as you can imagine, here in the control center. But once we cleared that, we were about 30 seconds away from launch, had a nominal drop from the L-1011. We had a nominal ignition. First, second, and third stage burns were all very good. You may have heard we did lose downrange telemetry real time. We did have an aircraft in the Pacific Ocean downrange that was scheduled, that did pick up the telemetry data from Pegasus. However, due to an onboard issue, they were unable to retransmit that data to us live. We do have that recorded on the aircraft, and we'll be reviewing that when the plane lands and we get those tapes.
All right, and I think we're watching for some video of the L-1011 about to touch down back here at Vandenberg. The indication, though, that we had a good flight actually came from the tracking data relay satellite, which told us the satellite was, I guess, where it should be, when it should be.
We were able to confirm that we had a nominal spacecraft separation from Pegasus. Even though we did not have the downrange telemetry asset, we did have the on-orbit TDRS network of satellites, and they were able to pick up and confirm spacecraft separation and turn on, and then give us that initial indication that all the initial sequence, including solar array deployment, was nominal.
Here comes the chase plane. We're not going to cover that. Okay, well, let's put it up. That's our chase plane coming back that provided the video to us of the deployment and the drop.
Yeah, I'd like to thank our friends at Dryden for supplying us with that beautiful onboard chase video that we were able to see all afternoon.
So if the chase plane's on the ground, the L-1011 won't be far behind. So, Tim, we'd like to thank you very much for giving us a status. It appears that we've had a very successful launch, and at this point, it appears that we've also got a happy spacecraft on orbit.
We've got a very happy spacecraft on orbit. We've got a thrilled launch team on the ground, and this has just been a great couple of weeks that we've had here at Vandenberg. I would like to thank Colonel Baltz, the 30th Space Wing Commander, and his team provided exceptional support to us. We worked through a couple of difficulties on the range, but only cost us one day, and here we are with a successful launch on our backup day, and we're very happy. Would like to give a shout out to Albert Sierra. Albert, I hope you're still watching us from Brevard County. We miss you and we love you.
And Albert Sierra is one of our mission managers at Kennedy Space Center that's key to the launch services program, and has had a setback that we hope will bring him back onto the team here very shortly.
Absolutely.
So at this point, we're getting ready to show our launch replays, and we're also going to keep an eye out for the L-1011 arriving back here at Vandenberg. And once we get through that, then we'll be wrapping up our broadcast. Right now, we are 27 minutes, 59 seconds into the IRIS mission. This is Pegasus Launch Control.